Georgia State University police officer has been charged with rape and kidnap. Let's put up his picture. He's a lieutenant. Lieutenant Terry Payne, 59 years of age, turned himself in on Friday at the Gwinnett Detention Center after he was identified as a suspect. So they charged him with rape, kidnapping, and false imprisonment and violation of office. I'm going to explain that violation of office in just a moment. He has been suspended without pay, according to GSU. The alleged victim, who police confirmed is not a student at GSU, went to a hospital on Saturday after she woke up in an unfamiliar location and the suspect was raping her. Now, while this woman, who is a victim of a horrific crime, she's not a student at Georgia State University. But Georgia State University, they need to investigate if he has been predatory to any student while on campus. All right? The two of them met several months ago. They went on a date at a restaurant. This happened at a time previous. Authorities said the woman told the special victims unit detectives that she could only remember meeting him at the restaurant, having one alcoholic beverage and nothing else until she woke up while allegedly being violated. According to detectives, the assault took place at a hotel across the street from the restaurant. It looks like they have confirmed this, likely by witnesses or video, maybe both. Police said the woman's story is consistent with the use of a date rape drug. They are still waiting on the official toxicology reports. Let's go to the spokesperson for the local police there. Her name is Sergeant Jennifer Richter. She said Payne used his badge and authority to carry out the attack. So let me explain that part. When the cop decided to bring the person to a hotel or to an unfamiliar location, let me put it that way, she was out of it. And she was so out of it that it sparked suspicion. So in order to make himself seem above board, he started to flash his badge to individuals around him in order to continue his criminal activity. Boom, that's your violation of oath of office. Now, could they have still charged him with this while off duty? Yes, because he's post-certified, which is a standard allocated for moral behavior beyond your actual hours worked or working. So yes, they still could have, but this made it basically a slam dunk charge. All right, attorney, what are your thoughts here?
I think when it comes to acts of sexual misconduct, what we are actually looking at is a pattern of behavior. I don't think this is the only time that this gentleman engaged in this behavior, especially being in a position of power and able to use his badge to get people to surrender or people to cooperate in the way in which he wants. This is just the first time he's been caught, as far as I am concerned. And I'm really glad that the department is moving forward and doing something, and also that the school is to some extent holding him accountable, because again, this person and this behavior, the behavior is a pattern. This is just, that's how it works when it comes to sexual misconduct. And so I am not at all surprised that this person would use their position as a law enforcement officer to continue to coerce people.
Yeah, and I've done some lecturing at Georgia State University. It's a fine institution. And here's what I encourage the facility directors to do, as well as the leadership academically. Make sure there's an anonymous way for college students to provide tips, to provide information about possible misconduct by this officer or other people on campus. And if you already have that mechanism in place, make sure it is well promoted right now so that those who may have been adversely impacted by this individual can actually tell their story.